Hello there, it's Tanya Gabrielle, Wealth Astroneurologist. Welcome to your weekly astroneurology forecast for July 1st through the 7th. We actually begin July on a Monday this week, which is always fun. So the highlights begin on the 2nd, though, on Tuesday, and that's where we have the first of two big eclipses. This one is a total solar eclipse and new moon eclipse, and it happens in a very spectacular way because the sun and moon are together in Cancer at 10 degrees. Cancer is the sign that governs the fourth house. And so it's all about home and family and love and your ancestral past and your family history. It could be past life history as well. Cancer is about feeling safe and protected and belong. It's about security, internal security. So it's a very private sign. So it describes your internal frame of reference. Now, what makes this eclipse so exciting, though, is that the sun and moon are sextile to Uranus, and that's all about setting yourself free. So since Cancer rules the past, Uranus is coming in this beautiful harmonious sextile and saying, well, let's get free from the past. Let's change our frame of reference. Let's shift into a new positive landscape. Let's be fearless and let go of that which we took on from conditioning, from our parents, from our teachers, from our mentors, from media, from society, from the past. And let's just break through in a really positive way. And so this is the breakthrough eclipse. It sets you free to begin the second half of 2019 in a very positive way, a freeing way, a way where your home is where your heart is and you don't rely so much on expectations. Now the sun and moon are also square to Chiron, and that brings healing through love. Greatly enhanced for the next 6 months because eclipses have a 6 month impact on us. So this is a wonderful time to start therapy of any kind, physical, emotional, spiritual, massage, right? Making massage a big part of your life, maybe twice a month, maybe once a week. And also to not be so hard on yourself and so hard on others too. So engage in loving conversations, engage with your inner spirituality, awaken that connection to source, that kindness, that creativity, that love, right, that connects with others in such a beautiful way. So this eclipse is really liberating and freeing, and also is very much about coming back to your heart, making your home where your heart is. Now there are many other transits during this eclipse: Mercury square Uranus, Jupiter square Neptune, Saturn sextile Neptune, and so there's a lot to cover. I'm not going to be able to do it all in this weekly forecast, but you can go to my blog at tanyagabrielle.com for the big star code podcast forecast of this eclipse. It'll be up by now, so you can go ahead and watch that. Now, the second highlight of the week happens on Sunday, the 7th of the 7th. This is a double 7 code, so 7 is very much about acquiring wisdom, research, quiet time, going out in nature, and it looks like a lightning strike, so you get big aha moments, big downloads. So it's a day of serenity and peace. It's a day of going within, and it really mirrors what's going on in the stars because Mercury actually stations retrograde today at 4 degrees in Leo. So the star code on the 7th of the 7th means you need to rest more, you need to spend time alone, you need to rejuvenate, and Mercury, you know, stationing today means, hey, you need more rest. You need to look within and you need to express yourself in a way that comes from the heart. Leo rules the heart, and Leo's very expressive. It governs creativity. So, and the 4 degrees where Mercury is stationing right now and at a standstill is about getting your life in order, being practical and being real, being in integrity. So Mercury is stationing right as it squares Uranus and conjuncts Mars. This is really fiery energy. So you want to be very cautious in how you deal with others. You don't want to rush to conclusions, be rash. You definitely will express yourself more passionately because of the Mars and Leo impact, but your words need to carry inspiration, not aggression. So there's a lot of electricity with this. It's palpable, and your quest for independence is already aroused with the eclipse. It'll be even more, you know, activated with Mars. And so your will is really strong right now, and Mercury in Leo also strengthens that will, but you need to use discretion with how you communicate your new ideas and feelings. And definitely channel that inner fire into creativity. It's really important with Leo because, you know, even if you revisit something that you started around before, you know, before July is a great time because Mercury's retrograde. That's when you start, when you go back and you look at things. So go in, reflect, enjoy the energetic shifts of this week. It's a really powerful week. And to get the really big details for every day of the month, just click on the link below. It'll take you to a free excerpt for July's 19 Universal Month Code. And you can discover more about the Premium Wealth Forecast, which is where I go into such detail for this star code for every day. You get a PDF. It's marked up for the whole month. You get it before the month even begins, and I also include music that I specially select for each month that aligns with the star code. So click on that link below and have a gorgeous first week of July and total solar eclipse week.